Welcome back to the workshop. Is it that time of year again? It's Halloween all over again. This year we're going to be doing Ghostbusters 125th Ecto-1 with the new Slimer figure in it from Polar Lights. Let's take a look at everything in the box when you get yours. Now I know a bunch of you have built this up before, so this is nothing new to you. This is a perennial favorite. A lot of people have had this kit. Look at the size of that body. That thing is 10 inches long. Cadillac ambulances were massive. So let's take a look at all the cool stuff that'll be in the box when you get yours. This is a Snap-Tite kit. And of course, we will take it to the next level and make it a painted kit and do the detailing that any advanced modeler would want to do, showing you that anyone can take a nice snap kit and make something pretty special out of it. The interior itself is the size of a small boat. And you can see the nice detail on there. This kit has been around for a long time. They must have sold a gajillion of them over the years. And what they did this year was to bring it back out, re-release it. The molds are clean. We're not seeing a lot of flash on anything. And they included a cool Slimer figure this time. And that's pretty cool. So you can see the huge rack for the top of the vehicle with all their ghost-busting equipment on there. That's pretty sweet. We've got our white wall inserts. Those will have to be painted as well because the plastic is an off-white, not a bright white that I want it to be. We've got a big, heavy chrome tree with some small parts on the side. Look at the grill on that caddy. Now, we're just going to black wash and detail everything. We're going to leave the chrome because it is a Cadillac. And they had it all shined up in the show. She was all pimping. We've got our reflectors up there for our lights. And look at that rear bumper. I've got it upside down, but you can see it. Nice. And the chrome work is just beautiful. Of course, we got an additional tree here of small parts, lights, everything like so. Even the glass on this is big. And we're going to leave it in the box because I don't want to scratch it yet. But we've got our domes there. Look at the glass for the back. Now, the back windows were deeply tinted on the movie. So I'm going to see if I can replicate that. If not, it's not a big deal. We've got four wheels. We've got two sets of decals, little bag over here, just so you know, metal axles and screws, because it is a Snap-Tite kit that you technically can play with. Now we have water slide decals, which I'm showing you right now. Beautifully done. Lots of extra information on there. You're going to be able to detail the kit nicely. And we have stickers. If you buy this for the kiddos, and they want to put it together all by themselves, they want to push it all together because it's Snap-Tite, you can go with those stickers and put those on as well. The tires are the ones that have always been in the kit. They are no-name tires with the wide opening in the back so you can fit the wheels and the white wall inserts with a nice tread pattern. Now, of course, you could always convert this kit to an ambulance, and that would just take a little bit of extra work filling in the ceiling and stuff like that, some of the molds on the side. Here is the limited Slimer figure included in this edition, and that really makes it extra cool. Even if you already own it, you can get this cool little figure, and he just snaps on his base and push. I hope I'm doing it the right way. God, that looks uncomfortable for him, doesn't it? Let's see. There we go. And he'll stand right next to the car, so that's awesome. He's going to be right there next to the vehicle. Yep. When we're all done, we're going to have a little Slimer there. I'm going to go get everything degreased. And we're going to see if I can get some sub-assemblies done before I have to start painting. We'll see you soon. Wait a second. What? Wait. There's no sub-assembly show-off. No, there isn't really on this kit. There's only one thing that you can actually assemble before you start painting everything, if you're going to paint it up like me, and that is the fins on the body. All right? That is it. That's pretty much all there is to put on before we start painting everything. So instead of wasting time on a sub-assembly show-off, which would have just been all the exact same parts you just saw in raw plastic without doing anything to them, I glued the fins on. Then I went in and started shooting paint. You can see that nice gloss white paint on there. That's just Rust-Oleum gloss white right out of the spray can. I've got some flat white on a lot of other parts. We've got the interior getting worked on. You can see some overspray in the back, which won't matter. We'll cover that up. I've got the chassis over there painted in black. You can see that. It's just enormous for being underneath that Cadillac. And then we've got a bunch of other parts painted in black, like the dashboard. That needs to have a whole bunch of chrome accents added. We've got our ladder in black. The antenna needs to go silver now. We need to get in and start hand painting the giant equipment rack on the top for the roof. Same with all the doodads that attach to the equipment rack. We've got those all primered in white. We've got our white walls and white. Those are going to stay a flat white primer because tires wouldn't be super shiny. At least I'm not going to make them super shiny on this one. I think they look too fake. So what do I have to do now? Well, do a little accent painting on the interior, do the dashboard, snap that into place, and then paint the rear seats black, put some decals on the inside, leave the rest gray, and the interior is done. Very nice and simple. We have to paint the accessory hoses blue and detail those. We have to do the dash. We have to do the steering wheel and all these little extra parts on there. You get the color guide in the manual, or I'm just going to use the box over there to guide me. On the grill, there really is not anything painted. We have to black wash inside that grill, and then I'm going to take the chrome off the headlights and actually do them with a chrome pen to bring them down a little bit. Same with the lower lights there so that they're not as chromey. We have to start putting some blue tint on these lights here. We have to start putting some red tint on the taillights and on the cone taillights up on the top there. We have to black wash the wheels, add their center cap details, and get those attached with the wheels and tires. I need to find my spray tint for windows from Testers. I gotta find that can. It's somewhere. I'm gonna deep tint the back windows just like they are in the movie. Then we've got to assemble the tires and the wheels, get those together. We've got to do some more tinting. We've got to get the blue tint from Tamiya out and tint the lights blue and paint the center silver. So we've got a good amount of work left to do here. I'm going to start throwing some extra color on stuff. I'm going to detail the bottom of the chassis just to bring out the exhaust and the engine and do the silver pencil mark on there just to mark it up a little bit, but we're not going to do a whole lot on that. We're not going to be flipping it over a lot. Most of the attention is on the outside top of the vehicle, of course. So I'll get to working on that. I've got to do this in silver. I've got to do the door handles. I've got to do a lot of trim. A lot of trim before I can put the glass in. That's all going to be done with silver there. We've got to do the hood trim. We've got to get decals on after we get everything assembled. Quite a little work to do. I'm going to start painting right away on that rack. Get those tires together. Get those wheels washed. We'll come back for some extra parts when they've got color. Parts and paints and parts and paints and oh my god, oh, we got all kinds of stuff. We got the windows tinted with successive coats of Tamiya smoke. It still requires more, but we're going to get it on there. We're going to deep tint those back windows nice and dark. We've got the light bars painted with their centers. Just need a couple more coats of metallic on there to cover it up. We've got the accessory hoses painted blue. They need their silver trim rings to be attached. We've got the bottom painted. I just did a very basic exhaust. I'll do the silver pencil technique where I just rub it on there. We've got the beautiful wheels done. Check those out. We just blackwash the centers. And on the decal sheet, like we showed you, there are Cadillac emblems for those centers. We've got everything else painted that needs to be painted. We'll give you a look at the dashboard. Now, I went very simple, as if the guys had worked on it and fixed it up, but didn't make it too fancy. But we've got this, you know, the speedometer gauges on there. We've got the steering wheel. It's a nice basic black dash. It is a Cadillac, but it was an ambulance. It was a fleet vehicle, so we have to take that into account. Plus, the guys didn't have a lot of money. It's doubtful they would have spent a lot of money putting in a fancy dash back in. We've got the beautiful grill done. The headlights are done in Molotel chrome to make them look a little bit more like glass. And then we blackwashed that grill and rubbed it back out with toothpicks until we just had that in the recession. And that looks absolutely beautiful. The taillights are the same. We washed the insides with Tamiya Clear and the upper taillights there on the fins. And that looks fantastic. We're going to leave that bright chrome work. And we've got the blue spotlights on the front and back. We've got the electron cannon painted. We've got the siren, we've got the grill on that blackwashed, and we've got the red spotlight tinted appropriately for the model. So, we've got everything hand-painted in here except for these. I had that beautiful blue spray paint, and I wanted to shoot those, and it would stick on well, so that looks great. Everything else has been hand-painted. We're going to start doing some assembly. What I have to do is complete the chrome trim on the body. Once I do that, then I can snap the windows into place. And then I can snap it on the chassis. Once it's on the chassis, I can decal everything. Then I can start placing the final parts on the top of the body, and we'll pretty much be done. So once I get the chassis attached with the interior inside, the interior is just a basic black, all right? Cadillac, I did highlight the phone, the calculator in the middle, whatever that device is, and did a basic green-gray paint job on the back interior. You really can't see it. And it doesn't have an opening door that, you know, they slide their packs out of, so there's no sense in detailing the interior in the back whatsoever. The front is just done up in black like it would have been. Now, I based my colors off the interior, before you start whining and complaining, off the Blitzway 1/6 scale $1,300 Ecto-1. It's like 3 feet long. It's massive. I based it off that, interior pictures of that, which was just basic black. Now, if they say it's basic black, they've looked at the real one, they've designed it, they're selling a model kit for a fortune, I'm going to just follow their lead and go with that. So if you have any problems with that, I don't care. That's the way it looks on the Blitzway creation. That's the only real interior pics I could find of one that they looked at, the movie one. That's what we're going with. So I got to start putting everything together. Once I get a lot of stuff on the roof rack, I'll snap the roof rack into place and the lights. Then I can start placing decals after I get the windows snapped in and the chrome trim. We'll come back for another update. We'll just look and see how things are progressing, and it's going great so far. It won't be long now. We'll have a final to the Ecto-1. I'm still working on the accessories. What I have to do now that I've done the chrome trim, I did that with a Molotow liquid chrome pen. And it feels like you're going to use half the paint on the side windows, the hood, get all your trim on there, your fins, your side markers. Then I've got the grill on, and that looks delightful. What we need to do now on this big white slab-sided monster, I've got the lights snapped on. I've got to do some paint touch-ups, got to do some chrome touch-ups. Then I'm going to be laying on the water slide decals on the fins and along the top of the body here, along the top of the door. The main reason I have to do those right now before I go any further is because I have to put hoses and lines and accessories over the back halves of the car out of these holes in this, and I don't want to try to have to slide the decals in there. Also, the decals will cover up my little slip on the chrome pen there, and it'll, you know, clean that up for me. I won't put any more decals on until I have the whole thing assembled. Then I'll be able to put the door emblems on, the emblem on the trunk, and you can see how nice that tailgate looks and how nice that rear bumper goes on there. And then we'll get it all together. I do have it screwed together. It's on the base. It is a roller because it has those nice metal axles, and it's a snap tight. Have to put the emblems inside the wheels, and then all I got to do is snap the parts rack in, get my hoses attached, get my different tanks attached and decaled, and all the different colors and all the oxygen tanks and the blue lights pushed in front and rear, and we're going to have a final. So when I come back, if there's no other issues, when I come back, we'll have a nice final to take a look at this sweet Ecto-1 from Ghostbusters. We're getting closer. We're almost ready to call them. But I've cleaned up the chrome trim. I got the first set of decals on. I could put the tailgate decal on and the license plates because they're not in the way of anything. I just love having Slimer hang out. We've got everything wet because I have given them a very strong coat of Mark Fit. I've also gone around for all the glass and rubbed it down with my Future floor polish. That makes glass really, it makes plastic really look like glass. I've done the same for my lights on top. Another thing that Pledge Future floor finish works beautiful on is when you cut clear plastic parts like the windshield, these bubbles off your plastic trees, and you'll get a white mark where the plastic was cut. You can cut that off with your X-Acto knife, but also give it a little dab with a Q-tip of Future floor polish, and that'll clean that right up. So all the chrome is done now. We've got it cleaned up. We've got it all ready to go. All I'm doing is waiting for the decals to dry on the other parts. I've also clear coated those, so I want to make sure that they're going to be nice and glossy up on the roof and shiny and new. So I'm waiting for that to dry completely. Then I'll be able to snap everything together, and we will have the final of the Ecto-1 when we come back. Here she sits in all her glory, the gorgeous 59 Cadillac Ambulance Ecto-1 from Ghostbusters, the original, the real Ghostbusters, the one we all know and love from the 80s. And isn't that fantastic? And this is a snap kit. And look at the detail even a beginner could get just grabbing some craft paints and putting some paint details on the extra parts. And she looks absolutely wonderful. Let's go through some of the products we used in this one. We used Tamiya Smoke to tint the windows in the back. We used Tamiya Clear Blue to tint all the blue lights and the blue lights up in front, and the spotlight, just like it is on the box in the movie. We use those products for that. We used a Tamiya Clear Red to do the taillights of the same thing. We used a Rust-Oleum Gloss White, just a regular old spray can of gloss white, to do the white work on the vehicle. And then we clear coated that body with Rust-Oleum Clear, which gives us a nice gloss finish. The decals went on well. I did use decal solvent to make sure that they conformed to everything nicely. You can use your whatever brand. They all work absolutely fine to make sure that all the decals went on, formed around the curves of all the little tanks and weather radio and all that stuff going on there. I love all the extra waterside decals to enhance everything. They just look wonderful. Now, I didn't do any work on washing out the seams of the doors because it's a white vehicle. What I did in advance was took my seam scraper, you can get these from Squadron Tools, and just scraped out all the door jams and divisions and around the trunk, scraped all that out, and then the doors will show up just fine on a white vehicle. If you put a black wash in there, it might be a little too dark, a little too garish. Everything else looks absolutely wonderful. Always use that Future Floor Polish I showed you on the glass. Get that to shine up. You can even use it on the clear parts up top. She is just absolutely, I love the new Slimer figure. Take a good look at him. I used a mild green wash from Army Painter on him just to enhance a couple of the folds of his slime there, give him a little more of a shape to it. But we have a beautiful kit here. Everything went nice. The decals worked great. We didn't have any problems. I also wanted to show you that you do get a clear radome, or a white radome for the microphone. They also include back here a clear one, which is the one I use to replicate the actual movie with the stripe around it and the small decals. We got our weather antenna, our electron cannon. We got some oxygen tanks. We got some hazardous tanks here. So we got all kinds of cool equipment on this bad boy. Now, the back door doesn't open, so I didn't bother doing much with the interior with the windows tinted and everything. If you wanted to super detail the interior, that'd be great. You could leave the windows clear. You could do whatever you wanted and make them look awesome that way. But just as it is, out of the box, she's a good-looking rig, and she's going to hold a beautiful place on the shelf. I can't wait to build Ecto-1A. Also, when you're all done, if you use the water slides, you got the sweet decals left. You can see that I needed them. I actually used one of the license plates on the front here. What happened was I put the water slide one on there, and it hangs off just a little bit off the edge, and I went to pick up the car, and I chipped the decal. So using the vinyl sticker, you really can't even notice the difference. It looks wonderful on there. Great kit. Goes together well. Been out forever. Re-released with that sweet Slimer figure. Ready for you to pick up. Happy Halloween, by the way. Little trivia. This is the 52nd model build on the channel this year. All right? We will see you folks with another review. We got the big Katinga coming up. We're going to be working on that bad boy, and that'll be our next kit review. We'll see you soon. Thanks for watching The Workshop.